Any fireman will tell you, fire and water are natural enemies, like dogs and vacuum cleaners. But like many relationships, this one is a little more complicated. Nabil has more.
Not to scare you, but if all the water on planet Earth was represented by 26 gallons, then just a measly half teaspoon of that supply would be fresh, drinkable water. It's no wonder there's an entire field of study dedicated to understanding humanity's most valuable and scarce resource, our water supply. A hydrologist like Dr. Sonya Lopez at Cal State University uses math, science, and creative problem solving to learn how we can better care for our water supply.
I hope my work impacts the world by making sure that water is available for everybody and that 100 years from now, my children, my children's children can turn on their tap and have clean and fresh water too.
I headed to Castaic Lake, a reservoir in Southern California, to learn more. So you're an engineer, right?
I'm a civil engineer. What most people don't know is that civil engineering has a whole bunch of subdisciplines, but I specifically focus on water resources, and under that is hydrology, sustainability, resource management, and environmental science.
Dr. Lopez takes all those scientific disciplines and creates computer models to help explore and protect groundwater systems. And according to a government study from 2018, the U.S. uses 82.3 billion gallons of groundwater every day. It's Dr. Lopez's job to understand how events above ground affect our supply below.
Do you see that patch of land over there?
Yeah.
That's called a fire scar. So about a year ago, there was a major fire that burned about 140 acres.
It might seem like the danger's over once the fire is extinguished, but that's far from true. Once the burning stops, a whole host of new problems begin, starting with the soil.
The vegetation that's burned, it settles into the soil, and it creates what's called a hydrophobic layer. It's sticky, it repels the water, so it runs off the surface.
So kind of ironically, wildfires cause floods?
Oh, they absolutely do cause floods.
To demonstrate this change, Dr. Lopez introduces me to the water penetration test. One of these pots has healthy soil. The other has been burned, leaving a fire scar, just like on the side of the hill.
I want you to put a few drops on each of the pots, and I want you to tell me what you see.
Okay.
In the first pot, the soil absorbs the water.
They're doing what I would expect in that they're soaking into the soil.
In the second pot,
what? They're like bouncing off.
That's right, and they're not going anywhere because that soil doesn't want it to go in. It's specifically hydrophobic.
Come on, soil, it's just water.
How does this relate to our water supply?
So the water basically carries anything that's on the soil downstream. There's microplastics, there's contaminants that we put in our lawn, there's bacteria. Everything gets carried downstream.
Once the contaminants enter the lake, they're a part of our water supply. To illustrate this, Dr. Lopez and I build models of a groundwater system. We add rocks, representing soil, and dig a hole for a well, representing our human water source. The empty space in the corner will become the reservoir.
Now, the next thing we're gonna do is add a little bit of water, kind of like rain.
Cool.
Although the lake and the well aren't touching, the lake fills the well up through the groundwater system underneath. Then we apply red food coloring, representing contaminants, and make it rain again.
What do you notice about the lake and our well now?
It's changing color.
Absolutely. Those contaminants are now in our well.
Oh.
So we can perfectly see this purple color here, and that's the combination of our fresh water and our contaminants.
I'm not showering in this water.
So I hope you can see the connectivity between how things move on the surface and then how they eventually get into our water systems.
Well, thank you for having me. I mean, you taught me so much today.
We've only covered a small fraction of hydrology. Anybody that's interested in studying hydrology or water resource engineering can make a huge impact in the amount of water that we can conserve and make a brighter and better future.
That's something we can all raise a glass to.